I hate you.
Why don't you die already?
You're such a nerd.
You are so stupid.
No one likes you.
You wear the weirdest clothes in the world.
Harmless things, kids say? Not really. And now, kids are saying these things with their fingertips. It's called cyberbullying, and it's now against the law.
A Nevada revised statute 392.915. Threatening to cause bodily harm or death to a pupil or school employee by means of oral, written, or electronic communications. What does that mean? Cyberbullying.
Cyberbullying includes texting or using social sites like Facebook to send mean and hurtful messages to others.
There isn't a community in the nation, a school district in the nation, that is not experiencing the issues as it pertains to cyberbullying.
Bullying has been going on since the beginning of time.
I've seen people get thrown in trash cans. I've seen people just get jumped.
But technology has now made it a whole lot easier to be a bully.
I think cyberbullying is more popular than physical bullying because now you could like text them like mean things without having to say it to their face, and that's kind of easier than having to say it to their face.
20% of children admit to having been bullied. Another 20% admit to doing the bullying. Yet most parents are oblivious to the problem.
Research has shown over the last 3 years that only 15% of all parents who have middle or high school age children even know what cyberbullying is. That means 85% of the parents out there have no idea of cyberbullying.
That's because cyberbullying is underreported.
A lot of kids are afraid of retaliation. They're afraid to be called a tattletale or a snitch. And they feel like the situation will escalate if they come forward.
Kyle West says he can't understand why a victim would not come forward, especially when it could save a life.
It just takes you telling. Who cares about, you know, snitching and things like that? I mean, I've heard people talk about it. Like, oh man, this person snitched for doing this and stuff, but at least they help save themselves and the other person.
The minute that another child comes forward for another child, hopefully that opens the floodgates.
Because many children don't tell anyone they're being bullied, parents need to be aware of behavioral changes.
That they're becoming withdrawn, that their grades are dropping, that they're avoiding outside communication, whether it be on the telephone or the computer, or even going outside to deal with other children.
Sometimes, though, the pain of cyberbullying can have deadly consequences. On January 14, 2010, 15-year-old Phoebe Prince, a Massachusetts high school student, committed suicide as a result of constant bullying.
Thankfully, Southern Nevada has not been part of that statistic where children commit suicide as it relates to cyberbullying. Those hurtful words. A child feels there's no other place to turn but then to death. That's not acceptable here in our community.
For more information on cyberbullying, please visit cyberbullying.us or stopcyberbullying.org.